Hi, everybody. Okay, so this is February 2nd, and we are doing the February 2nd reading of Melody Beattie's The Language of Letting Go. All right, so February 2nd, trusting our higher power. Made a decision to turn our will and our lives over to the care of God as we understood Him. Step three of Al-Anon. So much talk about a higher power, God as we understand God. So much joy as we come to understand Him. Spirituality and spiritual growth are the foundations of change. Recovery from codependency is not a do-it-yourself task. Is God a relentless taskmaster? A hard-hearted, shaming wizard with tricks up his sleeve? Is God deaf? Uncaring? Haphazard, unforgiving? No. A loving God, a caring God, that is the God of our recovery. No more pain than is necessary for usefulness, healing, and cleansing. As much goodness and joy as our heart can hold, as soon as our heart is healed, open, and ready to receive. God, approving, accepting, and instantly forgiving. Whew, that line's making me tear up a little bit. It's a good God. God has planned little gifts along the way to brighten our day, and sometimes big, delightful surprises, perfectly timed and perfectly for us. A master artist, God will weave together all our joy, sadness, and experience to create a portal of our life with depth, beauty, sensitivity, color, humor, and feeling. God, as we understand Him, a loving God, the God of our recovery. Whew. Today I will open myself to the care of a loving God. Then I will let God show me love. Wow. So for me today, this is a beautiful reading. I went through a really strenuous, I think that's the right word, extraneous trauma therapy session yesterday, and then I spoke with my best friend who's also on a spiritual healing journey, and everything we just read nails it from what I just experienced yesterday. Yeah, I'm experiencing a lot of pain, a lot of what did it say here? What were the words? Do it yourself and caring. No more pain than is necessary for usefulness, healing, and cleansing. That's what I have been embracing most recently is embracing the pain, letting the pain come instead of trying to distract myself from it, whether it be distracting it, distracting myself from the pain through exercise or through art, even good, good ways of healthy escape tools that I've developed. I decided to not even use those and really embrace the pain. And this reading is telling me I'm doing the right thing because there's cleansing in that. There's pain that is necessary for usefulness, healing, and cleansing. So that's been a big part of my recovery journey is allowing the pain to come, feeling it, embracing it, and learning from it and cleansing from it. So this reading basically today is telling me that I'm on the right path. And yeah, God has planned little gifts along the way to brighten our day. That's true too. As I've been facing this pain, as I've been embracing it, there is, these in throughout my day, it's like a moment of like, oh, intense pain. And then a moment of like, wow, like what a great surprise. Look at this gift that just came, my way. So yeah, on this journey of spirituality, I think we gotta learn to endure all the feelings. We can't have happiness without having sadness. We can't, there's polar opposites to everything in this universe. So if I want happiness, I gotta be able to also embrace the pain and the sadness. And the more I do that, the more I realize, even in the midst of the sadness and the pain, I can feel a sense of gratitude. And I was talking to my friend last night and I said it's so weird to articulate this because I can sense gratitude. It's not like I'm feeling gratitude, but I can sense gratitude while I sit here in pain. which is just baffling to me. It's the spiritual journey is so wildly amazing. I'm in awe of it. I could never, unless until we feel it, we can't. For me, that's the message that I'm getting. Until I go through it and feel it, I could never anticipate it. I could never say to myself prior to this moment that, oh, I'm going to go through this because I'm going to feel this and this. Like my brain couldn't fathom, or my mind couldn't fathom, or my heart couldn't fathom how I could feel gratitude in the midst of deep sorrow. So I think that is like a main cusp of this journey, is really trusting, like it said, trusting that higher power, and letting go into it, allowing all of these moments to come without distracting myself from it, without detouring from it, without pushing it away. Welcoming it all, embracing it, and I have a very, very strong intuitive sense that after, a few months of going through this journey, I'm going to come out on the other side a very evolved spiritual human being. So I'm looking forward to it, and I hope you guys stay on this journey with me. We got a reading every single day. Thank you so much for watching. This is Light Up Your Life with Lisa. Keep coming back. Love you all. Bye.